First of all, I would like to thank Deepshika and SpeakIn team for conducting such a beautiful event and giving us the opportunity to come and share our thoughts. So thank you so much. So what's all the motivation? I was reminded of a time in my life. Things from how dare it happen to me? How is this going to happen to me? How did this happen to me? Cut to 2 weeks later, when I'm thinking, why did God do this to me? Of all the people in the world, is it me? I mean, He could just pick me. So yes, it's the old and scary failure. I was going through a time in my life where I faced failure in health, in career, in relationships, failure in general. So fortunately, for me, for my husband, for my family, I've been able to recover most of this and I'm still in progress for a lot of things. So what I would like to discuss today and I'd like to talk about the thing, what we should be doing to overcome failure, and most importantly, what we should not be doing to overcome failure. I've seen this in a lot of people. When they encounter failure, first thing they tend to do is ignore it. You know, for example, you go and write an exam. It did not go through well. You come back and the first thought, you tell yourself, you know what, I just gave it for the heck of it. I was not serious about it. I've read 2 books about it. I went and I wrote the exam. Stop doing that. Respect the time that you've spent. Respect the energy that you've spent. Respect the fact that you prepared for the exam. You went all the way. You wrote the exam. You came back. You evaluated it. Stop denying yourself of that respect. Second point, what I have is related to the first point. But people tend to undermine it. You know, you've given a job interview, it did not go well. You come back and you tell yourself that, you know what, the job was anyways not for me. I've heard so many things about that job. I've heard there are a lot of, you know, the culture is not good and everything. You are trying to be arrogant here. Stop doing that. Your goal, respect what you have. Do not take pride in the fact that you are insulting something and then you're becoming a bigger version of yourself. Stop doing that. Personally, I've not done this third point, but I've seen a lot of people doing it, shifting blame on others. You know, they come back home. For example, a husband has given an exam. He comes back home to his wife and he says, you know what, this exam, I could have gotten 100%, I did not get it because you took me out shopping on that day. I was supposed to prepare for that particular subject. See, conveniently, he's blaming it on her. Stop doing that. You did not get through. It's your fault. You can't blame it on her. You can't blame it on others. Right? Fourth thing, what I would like to discuss, which I am guilty of, is when I encounter any failure in any phase, is obsessing myself over it. I keep asking, what's wrong? Why did this happen to me? Why? And I also start troubling everyone else. I go and ask my husband, you think that was what I was done wrong here? You think that was where the issue was? They have a lot of other things to do in life as well. They won't be, you know, they'll tell you once or twice, it's going to be the same answer. It's not going to be changing every now and then. You need to be confident even about your failures. So, ignoring it, undermining it, obsessing yourself over it, blaming on others, and most importantly, when you disrespect what you have gone through, is not the way to go about. What you should do instead is accept it. When I'm saying accept it, it's not saying continuously in your mind, I'm a failure. No, that's not what I meant. When I'm saying accept it, say yourself, yes, something has gone wrong. Yes, something is bad. I am going to have to evaluate what is it that has gone wrong. I'm going to have to work on it. Evaluate your options. Evaluate plan B if you have any. Evaluate where is your goal and where are you. If you want to be an IAS officer, see the intent of it. Is it for pride? Is it for money? Is it for something else? Or is it that genuinely you want to serve the country? Go back to the drawing board. Have a plan of action. Your plan of action is not like 2 months I'm going to study this subject, 2 months I'm going to study that subject. No, it cannot be as vague as that. It should be as clear and as concise as 5:30 to 6 a.m. in the morning, I'm going to study this chapter. Back in the evening and review your action plans. When you give that, you know, when we were in school, we would give that tick mark, right? That the teacher would give that tick. So when you give, you spend that 15 minutes just before sleeping to see what is it that I'm doing. And have I achieved that day's goal? Just stick it and say, yes, I've done that. You won't believe the sense of confidence that comes in you, the inner strength that's built on you. That is saying to you that, okay, maybe you got it. Maybe there is something there. You're able to achieve this. So, all in all, I'd like to conclude by saying that failure may be your most bitter enemy today, but it's an excellent teacher for your tomorrow. Thank you so much.